I'm from Arkansas, and they brought me all the way down here. You know, I was trying to get back home, and I felt like, you know, I was kind of a little coerced in it. You know, I believe drinking did help a lot. You know, I've been in jail for 414 days, you know, and I sit there and I think about it, you know, how I would feel. You know, I was young and dumb. I have no excuse, you know, of why I did it. You know, it was wrong. You know, I know that God, he do everything for a reason, but I'm not using that for an excuse to why I made a stupid choice, you know. But sometimes the people, you know, bad company corrupt good character. You know, I'm a good person. I just feel like that I was just around the wrong people, and then I just wasn't strong enough to just say no, feeling like that I probably had to be cool to just do something that I knew that probably was wrong. You know?
New instructions somewhat defined a little better, but it's not an hour, an hour and a half driving around with a gun stuck to your head or to be pointed at you. Tell you that you're not going to see your children again unless you cooperate. Telling them that you're going to be killed if you don't cooperate. This is repeated comments, threats to kill to this victim. Could well have been satisfied with the first robbery. I would have wanted more money and continued with this kidnapping and drove or had this victim drive around that end of Clarksville trying to get the money out of ATM. At least one gun pointed at him, perhaps another to the back of his head. To me, that's exceptional cruelty. Much more necessary to accomplish the act of aggravated kidnapping. That's all the enhancement factors and the mitigating factors. In weighing that, those two factors, I'm going to send it to 10 years in each count, concurrent with each other, pursuant to the agreement.